Now question number 6 in exercise 6.3. This is very simple problem. You are given the side QR of triangle PQR is produced to S. So for this question you are using the property exterior angle is equal to sum of the interior opposite angle. I think already you know this property. This is triangle. If you produce one side like this, this will be the exterior angle and this is interior opposite angle. You should not take this is interior opposite angle, this angle, because this is the adjacent angle of this angle. Adjacent angle means common ray, angles with common ray. So common ray angles you should not consider. You are considering the ray, the angles, they are not touching this. So this is interior opposite angle. This is first one. Suppose if you produce the side like this. This is exterior angle and this x and y are interior opposite angle. So first side will produce, this side also will produce, or in this way. You produce like this. This is exterior angle and this is interior opposite angle. So when you consider the interior opposite angle, you should not consider this adjacent angle. That should keep in mind. This sum of these two is equal to, if we add, this is equal to this angle. If you add, this is equal to this angle. If you add, this is equal to this angle. So this is the property we are using in this question. And also it is given angle bisector, the side is produced with it. Here it is given the bisector. Angle bisector means half of this, you know. This is equal. These two angles are equal. Now you want to prove QTR equal to half of QPR. QTR, this is equal to half of this one. This only you want to find. Now for this solution, consider the triangle PQR. Consider the triangle PQR. Now which is the exterior angle? Exterior angle PRS. PRS. PRS means in this way also you can consider, but you are considering only the exterior angle. So this is the exterior of this one. So exterior of PRS is equal to sum of the interior opposite angle. Sum of the interior na angle P plus angle PQR, or you just write angle Q. This is angle Q. Hope you understand. This exterior angle is equal to sum of the interior opposite angle, and just divide by 2. Divide by 2, divide by 2. So in the next step you do divide by 2. Therefore exterior of PRS by 2 is equal to angle P by 2 angle Q by 2. What is PRS by 2? PRS by 2. This is nothing but here which one? This TRS. Here you can write TRS. This is angle bisector. If we divide it by 2, these two angles are equal. So you give the name as TRS equal to angle P by 2, this angle Q by 2. This angle Q by 2 means you give the name TQR. This is TQR. Whole angle by 2. Whole angle by 2. This Q by 2 means you can say PQT as well as TQR. So you write it as TQR. This you mark it as 1. Now consider the triangle QTR. You consider the triangle QTR. First triangle PQR, then next one is QTR. Use the same property. Here you write exterior angle, which one? TRS. TRS. When a triangle we draw separately, this is டி தென் யூ தென் ஆர் அண்ட் திஸ் ஸோ திஸ் ஆங்கிள் இஸ் த எக்ஸ்டீரியர் ஆங்கிள் TRS is equal to what is interior opposite angle? If you consider this, this is interior opposite angle. That is TQR. Then plus another one is angle T. Just you write QTR means that's the angle T. Or in this TQS you can write Q by 2 also. Now you can substitute For TRS, you can substitute this one. The answer is long. So now, from 1 and 2. So from 1 and 2, TRS, you can substitute instead of TRS, you can write this. TRS equal to angle P by 2, plus angle TQR. So instead of TRS, you are writing this TQS plus angle T equal to angle P by 2, then angle TQR. TQR, TQS, same only. TQR, TQS, both are same only. This just measuring the measurement is not different, only the length is different, the ray name, the name of the ray is only different, but measurement is the same only. So this and this will be cancelled, therefore angle T is equal to, you can give the name as RPQ, half of angle RPQ. So this only we want to